Dr. Lalisang, the incidence of small liver cancer is increasing and the treatments are various. How do you select patients for cancer transplantation?
Yeah, as mentioned, like in my talk, you know, my slide, the first, you know, we must include the tumor behavior. We're not anymore directly only think about the number and the size, but now the criteria must be for to decide liver transplant or not. It is more important the behavior of the tumor. So you must put like differentiation and the markers of the tumor, like IFP, PIFCA, or good differentiation. So if it is small and the child PUG, the liver condition is in A, so first I will be choice liver resection, not liver transplant. Especially why I said like this, because in Indonesia, the donor is what not enough donor, I know, but the donor, cadaveric, it is not ready for, it is not working right now, the cadaveric, but even the living donor, what we, I call, it is not ready. So even we have already, we can choose choose the donor, but you know, to prepare the donor, it is not, it just takes time. So usually we will it is not justified for in a small one when resection can be done, better resection can be done as long the liver condition is good and the remnant liver will be still enough. But then, if in small tumor, I think if the child PUG is more than B or C, B or C. So that is because small, we are not talk about the remnant liver because it is still will be enough. We are thinking more about the liver condition. But the important thing is also because living, if we are using living donor, it is a little bit different because we must be fair for the donor. If we are facing with a very high recurrence, a very aggressive tumor, EGC aggressive like a very high IFP, I think it is not also justified to, even the, it is the donor can be give this, the liver, I think it is not what we call not fair, because with very high recurrence will be happening.
What are the main risk factors for recurrence after liver transplantation?
Yeah, it is still in the study, but before we already know if you have a underlying disease like B or C where it is not controllable before, and they have an B and C impact to make the EGC, I think we are facing with a very high recurrence. The second is the behavior. If we all know it is a very poorly differentiated EGC or very large one, and there are already what we call in the margin, there are already invasion to the vascular, to vascular system, I think it is also a very suspected to be a very high recurrence. Operative technique is also very important. How long the ischemic cold and warm ischemic it is also, and how many bleeding you get. So technically, it is also important. So I think, because you're asking the last question is like this. First, you must have very good surgery technique, and also the the law for to how to manage cancer, liver cancer, tumor, it must be followed, like no touch anymore, no manipulation to heart. And also the condition. And one, I think the prevention is to control the underlying disease, the Hep B or the Hep C. Mm-hmm.
You mentioned before we started this interview, you have some connections in China. You've been to China. You have friends there?
I have many friends because I learn liver transplant first. I go to Hangzhou, and then I know the connection with Professor Chen Xiaoping. He was one of the president of Asia-Pacific HPB Association before, in the past. And now he is the president of China chapter of HPB. And there's many friends, also in Taiwan, also in Hong Kong.
So your Chinese colleagues are listening to you now. Thank you very
much. Hopefully. And I will regards and hopefully they will overcome the coronavirus as soon as possible.
Well, that's they're fighting the fight.
Yeah, I hope there will be very good and be overcome the problem.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, welcome.